What's up, guys? Nick here with a brand new unboxing video. How long has it been since the last one? I don't know. I don't even remember what the last one was. Really don't. that's pretty bad. Let's see. I did get Xbox One again, which I might have been the next unboxing video. Now, we got a new game on the list. I started playing the Sniper Elite series, well, one of them. I don't know. A month ago, maybe less, with Bud. He bought me Sniper Elite 2, which was like, was it $1, $3, something like that on Steam? Thank you. We played through it twice. Three times? Was it three? Yeah, it was three times. The first time was just us playing around. The second one tried to record, and the second one didn't. Nope, maybe it was just two. I don't know. But, now, I saw it somewhere that they were making another one, well, which was on the main screen. So, I was glad to pick it up. Sniper Elite 3. I'm actually excited to play this one because it's kind of cool. The first game is awesome. The second game is awesome. The slow-mo shots are cool like that. I saw a video of this somewhere, and I'm like, okay, that I'm sold. I saw the gameplay. I'm like, I'm sold. Now, you don't have to be stealthy, but it's implied that you need to be, because the enemies aren't stupid. They're smart. So, here's our main character on the front from Rebellion and 505 Games. It's better than 343. Not really. Rated M for mature, obvious reasons. One bullet can change history. North Africa, 1942. The heat is on. Germany is building a wonder weapon with the power to crush any Allied forces in its path. The infamous Africa Corps, which spelled with a K for some reason, which on the front of the game, K. Corps and their fearsome tiger tanks stand in your way. Sabotage their plans. The Allied resistance is over. Or the Allied resistance is over. I'm not reading that well. Observe, plan, execute, adapt. Stalk the shadows or go loud. Set traps, evade, and relocate. Always hunt on your own terms. Also, another thing about that game. If you relocate to a different location, toward, like you shoot an enemy, they don't see you, and you go somewhere else, they actually forget that you were even there. Which is, in a way, kind of dumb. It's like, oh, where'd this bullet come from? Well, we're going to forget. Multi-route environments, expansive non-linear levels, multiple objectives, more choices, more verticality, and longer shots. Awesome. This game is specifically made to be a sniper. There's some levels in games where you're supposed to be a sniper. They're not really that long a distance. It's just be silent. I like the box art, though. For some reason, I just like this box art. Next-gen X-ray kill cam. More human detail than ever before, and now includes vertical vehicle takedowns. See tanks shred from the inside. In the second one, that when you shoot a tank, destroy a tank, which you can kill a tank by shooting its fuel, it will be awesome explosions. Online multiplayer. 5 pulse racing competitive multiplayer modes. 3 action-filled co-op modes. Co-op campaign. Now, the first thing I saw about this when I looked at the box when I first got home, I looked for the co-op because I want it to be one-on-one co-op in the same room with somebody. It's not. It's online. So in order for me to play a bug, we're probably going to play online on Steam. But Steam's not a bad thing. In all actuality, for pinpoint aiming, computer's better. All right. Last part. Players, Xbox One, one player, meaning by yourself. Xbox Live, 2 to 12, which not that many. Could, you know, older games are like 16 and more. Co-op, Xbox Live 2. Rated M for blood and gore, intense violence and language. It should say intense blood and gore because look at that shit. You get to see the X-ray of an enemy and watch as their brains are exploded inside of their head. I saw it. It's graphic. It's kind of awesome. It's like the It's like the Gears of War headshots, except you get to see what's going on inside their head, not just... Alright. Time to open her up. And because I pre-ordered my copy, I got additional DLC, which I didn't know it came with it. And only put $5 down like a month ago on this game. So it's like, okay. Was it a month ago? No, it was like 2 weeks ago. Something. I don't remember. I don't remember how long ago it was I put this down. But it seemed like... I almost messed up the box. Almost messed up the box. That's gonna suck. Alright. And this makes my fourth Xbox One game, which already beats more PS4 games than I've had. I mean, PS4 is good and everything. I just think this is better than me. Now, again, let me show you an example. I'm used to the disc being on the right. This is how I'm used to. I'm not used to that yet. But the disc is on the opposite side. Yes, I grabbed Mass Effect. I grabbed like the last game on my shelf up here, or one of my shelves. And seven. Alright. The disc is it's pretty okay. It's better than using the same one. So, there's the disc. Looks pretty cool in my opinion. You know. What is this? It's a pamphlet. God damn it. Controller layout, warranty, instructions, or introduction, which we basically hit that at the bottom. Really? To zoom in, you do that? Huh. So, in order to aim, you have to half press without using a scope. What's half press? Yes. Whatever. And it was in here backwards. It wasn't like that. It was sitting in there backwards. I guess that's their choice. Alright, that's going to be on the shelf. I'll be playing that sometime soon. There was another game that I purchased the other day. I didn't do an unboxing video for it because it's an older game. Animal Crossing! I've never played any of the Animal Crossing. I've always wanted to play it though, try it out. It's actually pretty cool. There's no fighting and stuff like that. It's just fishing, using a shovel, catching bugs, stuff like that, making your own town, stuff. It's pretty cool, I guess. I'm not that big on it. Alright, little bit of an update. Let's plays do not, my let's plays now will not have a specific schedule. Bud's already said this before. He's like, really, you don't have to post them on a specific date because I don't have it stated, so. Because work and stuff, there's certain days, like today. It's the day after Truck Day. I'm really tired. I really don't feel like recording anything. And I'm behind on Mega Man. Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, I'm okay. I have an episode I can upload tomorrow. But Mega Man, I'm behind because it's the kind of game I have to get into. Pokemon, I'm always into it because it's simple. It's easy to do. Mega Man, you could die constantly if you're not that great. So, basically, games and stuff aren't going to have a specific schedule. Yes, I did say Pokemon Mystery Dungeon can come out tomorrow, but there might be a week where I don't do one game but do another. There might be a week where I don't do any games. There might be a week that both of them are up, and there might be a week where there's 5 days full of them. Because I get into playing a game, and I'm like, okay, I'm going to keep going. Then I have a bunch of episodes I want to upload. So, anyway, that's the end of this. I hope y'all enjoyed watching me ramble on about video games and stuff. And I hope to see you on the next unboxing video or Let's Play. Peace.